Customer Match helps navigate a tagless future by leveraging first-party data. It serves as a foundational pillar to help advertisers achieve their marketing goals, like retention and new customer acquisition, by driving smarter bidding and optimized targeting. Customer Match lets you use your online and offline data to reach and re-engage with your customers across search, the shopping tab, video, including YouTube, display, and Gmail. Similar to other criteria, customer lists can be targeted at the ad group or campaign level. In order to be targeted, a customer list must contain at least 1,000 active users. A typical usage flow of Customer Match in the Google Ads API might look something like this. First, create an empty user list for Customer Match. You'll need to select the type of data you're going to upload to this list, and can only upload one type to a given list. This can be contact info, which includes phone number, email address, and mailing address, CRM ID, which is matched from a user ID generated and assigned by the advertiser, and mobile advertising ID. We recommend using contact info where possible and adding multiple types of contact information for a given user to improve the chances that they're matched to a Google account. Next, create an offline user data job through the Offline User Data Job service. It's possible to use the user data service to add to your Customer Match user lists, but this is designed only for small updates of up to 100 user IDs per request, does not offer significant performance advantages, and updates made with this service won't appear in the Google Ads UI. Next, add operations to your offline user data job. Each operation contains a user data object, which represents a member of the user list and contains one or more user identifiers that you pull from your first-party data. For customer lists that contain contact information, these user identifiers can include email addresses, phone numbers, or mailing address info, all of which must be hashed according to the requirements. We recommend adding up to 10,000 identifiers in a single call for optimal processing. Repeat the Add Offline User Data Job Operations API request until all operations are added or until the job is at capacity. We recommend no more than 1 million operations in a given job. Once your job is ready, run it with the Run Offline User Data Job method. To ensure your match rate is ready to be verified and the list ready for targeting, we recommend polling the job for completion. The job is done once its status is either success or failed. It can take as little as 10 minutes or as long as 24 hours for a job to complete. Once complete, verify the match rate to ensure it meets expectations and your list has enough users to be targeted. Match rates can vary widely depending on how active your users are on Google Search, Gmail, or YouTube. If your match rate is lower than expected, it's also possible that the data was not formatted or hashed correctly before uploading. Once you've verified your match rate, you're ready to target your campaigns or ad groups to your customer list. Congrats! We're just about done, but first, a couple tips for getting started. First, make sure to review the requirements that must be met before you can use Customer Match and the policies you must follow to be able to target your lists. Second, review the documentation for best practices and examples to design an integration with minimal errors and optimal performance. If you have any questions or if you're looking for more videos like this one, be sure to leave us a comment. And if you found this video helpful, let us know with a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.